the mu'min? Who is the believer that is addressed in the hadith and the ayah? Allah said in Al-Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُوا. Another ayah, وَمَنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَإِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ سَعِيرًا. So the first ayah says that the believers are but those who believed in Allah and His Messenger and then had no doubt after that. The second ayah says, and that whoever does not believe in Allah and His Messenger, then indeed Allah has prepared for the blasphemers, for the non-believers, a blazing fire. So you could see in the two ayahs, the belief in Allah and the belief in His Messenger together are mentioned to define a believer, which means that whoever says, I believe that this world has a creator, I worship this creator, but I don't believe in Muhammad being a prophet of God or his prophet, then such a person is not a believer as per the ayahs. Allah said that whoever does not believe in Allah and His Messenger, He has prepared for the blasphemers, for the non-believers, a blazing fire. So Allah made it clear that whoever does not believe in Allah and also His Messenger, he is not a believer, he is a kafir, he is a non-believer, a blasphemer, misbeliever, disbeliever, whatever the word is. So we cannot, you know, consider a person to be a believer means a Muslim. That's what we mean. Within the Islamic fold, whoever says, I want to believe in God, but I don't believe in Muhammad being the prophet of God. This is not acceptable to consider such a person a Muslim. And the Prophet, for example, said in another hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, مَا مِنْ يَهُودِيٍّ وَلَا نَصْرَانِيٍّ يَسْمَعُ بِي ثُمَّ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِي وَبِمَا جِئْتُ بِهِ إِلَّا كَانَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. Any Jew or a Christian who hears of me, the Prophet says, and does not believe in me and what I brought, which is Islam, this Yahudi or Nasrani will be among the people of hellfire. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is telling us, as many verses in the Quran and many hadith and the consensus of the Muslims, that the only religion accepted by Allah is Islam. Any other religion is not accepted by Allah because it's not a true religion. Allah does not accept it. Only Islam was the prophets, all the prophets' religions. They came with one religion, which is Islam. Believing in Allah being the creator who deserves to be worshipped, the one who doesn't resemble his creation, the one who has power over everything, the one who knows everything, the one whose will goes through, and whatever he willed to be shall be, and whatever he did not will shall not be. To believe in the creator that he doesn't have partners, he doesn't have children, he does not get tired when he creates. Believing in this God is the correct belief in God. Otherwise, anything contradictory to that, to say God has parents, children, you know, helpers, that he got created heavens and earth in 6 days and he rested on the seventh day, other than that, anything like that is not belief in Allah. And believing in Muhammad being the messenger of Allah, the last one, the one who came with the Quran and the Sunnah, and that he is truthful in everything he brought. This is both believing in Allah and His messengers are necessary to make a person a Muslim. So all these concerted, organized calls by individuals, by institutions, by other things to merge, to make a salad of religions together, Islam and otherwise, are concerted efforts to derail you Muslims out of your religion. You should not accept that. Because if you have honey, which is sweet and pure, if you mix it with dirt, you mix it with filth, it's not gonna stay as honey. It's gonna be something else. It's not gonna taste honey. So those people who are trying to mix your Islam with something which is contradictory to Islam is trying to stain your commitment to Islam, and you should not accept that.
And you should know, brothers and sisters, that Allah, the Exalted, revealed in the Quran, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَرْتَابُهُ, that the believers are those who believe in Allah, the Exalted, and His Messenger without any doubt. Thus, the one who doubts about Allah, the Exalted, or doubts about the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is not considered amongst the Muslims. And Allah the Exalted said in the Quran, وَمَنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَإِنَّا عَتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ سَعِيرًا, that whoever does not believe in Allah and His Messenger, then he is a kafir. And indeed, we have prepared hellfire for the non-believers, for the kuffar, for those kafirs. And this means that whoever does not have the proper belief in Allah the Exalted, clearing Allah the Exalted and resembling the creation, attributing to Allah the Exalted the attributes of perfection, whoever does not carry the proper belief in Allah, and who does not carry the proper belief in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by clearing him of the attributes that all prophets are necessarily cleared from, and attributing to him the necessary attributes of the prophets, the person who errs in these fundamental matters, he is not considered amongst the Muslims. And Allah the Exalted has prepared hellfire for him. So the one who disbelieves in Allah the Exalted by attributing to Allah attributes of the creation, the one who disbelieves in Allah the Exalted by insulting Allah, by attributing to him attributes of deficiency, the one who disbelieves in Allah the Exalted by believing that Allah has created attributes, even if he said certain Islamic words, he is not judged as a believer, because what he carries in his heart clearly contradicts the Shahada, the core meaning of the Shahada. Thus, any person, no matter what their status is in one society or the next, or whatever title that person is given from one group or another, who belies the Quran, belies the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, disbelieving in Allah the Exalted, contradicting the saying of Allah, وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ, that nothing resembles Allah, no matter who he was, he would be considered among the non-believers. And if he dies on that status, he would have an everlasting state in hellfire as his punishment. And the Muslim is obligated to address such a person in this way. The person who believes that Allah the Exalted has created attributes, he's a kafir, and the Muslim must recognize him as such. The person who believes that Allah the Exalted has body parts like a human, he is a kafir, and so the Muslim is obligated to recognize him as such. The person who believes that Allah the Exalted is a volume that moves up and down in his creation, and his creation encompassed by the things that he brought into existence, this person will be a kafir, belying the saying of Allah, laysa kamithlihi shay, and the Muslim is obligated to recognize him as such. And if the Muslim, if the person who is attributed to Islam contradicts that and says that this person who cusses Allah, insults Allah, attributes to Allah attributes of imperfection, attributes of the creation, is still Muslim, then that itself is blessed. That is blessed. May Allah then exalt you, protect us from all of that.
الواجبات وأولاها. وأعظمها عند الله تعالى الإيمان بالله عز وجل. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم: ومن لم يؤمن بالله ورسوله فإنا أعتدنا للكافرين سعيرا. ومن لم يؤمن بالله ورسوله، الإيمان بالله أن تعتقد أن الله موجود لا يشبه الموجودات، موجود منزه عن الشريك والمثيل والأين والكيف، أنه لا يشبه شيئا من خلقه. ومن لم يؤمن بالله ورسوله، فإن الإيمان بالرسول ضروري واجب، أن يعتقد أن محمد عليه صلوات الله وسلامه صادق في كل ما أخبر به عن الله تعالى، فيجب الإيمان بذلك جزما. ومن كان على غير ذلك فهو الذي أخبر الله عنه في القرآن فقال: ومن لم يؤمن بالله ورسوله فإنا أعتدنا، هيأنا للكافرين. الكافرين هم الذين لم يؤمنوا بالله ربا، ولم يعتقدوا فيه ما يليق به سبحانه وتعالى. فإنا أعتدنا للكافرين سعيرا، نارا حامية الله تعالى توعدهم بها لكفرهم بالله. ولذلك عباد الله، لا ينبغي أن يلتفت إلى من يقول أن الناس سواسية عند الله لا ورب السماء والأرض، فإن الله في هذه الآية أخبر بأن من لم يؤمن به وبرسوله أعد له نارا عظيمة جاء وصفها في تمام الآية، فقال جل جلاله: ومن لم يؤمن بالله ورسوله فإنا أعتدنا للكافرين سعيرا، أي جهنم ملتهبة عليهم والعياذ بالله تعالى. وكذلك كثير من آيات القرآن بيّن الله فيها أنه لا يستوي في الآخرة عند الله من آمن بالله، من اعتقد بالله ربا لا شريك له، بمن كفر وجحد بالله أو نسب إلى الله ما لا يليق به. الكفار في زمن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام منهم من قالوا لما سمعوا القرآن: نحن لنا في الآخرة أكثر مما لكم، فقال تعالى في توبيخهم وتبكيتهم: أفنجعل المسلمين كالمجرمين ما لكم كيف تحكمون. أفنجعل المسلم الذي آمن بالله تبارك وتعالى وعبد الله ومات على ذلك كمن كفر بالله ونسب إليه ما لا يليق به من المكان والجهة والصورة والولد وغير ذلك؟ أفنجعل المسلمين كالمجرمين ما لكم كيف تحكمون. وكذلك قوله تبارك وتعالى: أفمن كان مؤمنا كمن كان فاسقا. الفاسق هنا هو الفاجر. وكذلك في قوله تعالى إخبارا عن أهل مكة الكفار الذين كانوا يتباهون ويتفاخرون في إعانة الناس وسقي الناس الماء البارد في ذلك الزمن، وقد كان شيئا صعبا، وأن هذا لهم فيه شرف، فقال الله تعالى: أجعلتم سقاية الحاج وعمارة المسجد الحرام كمن آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وجاهد في سبيل الله لا يستوون عند الله. لا يستوي المؤمن والكافر عند الله يوم القيامة، لا يستوي من آمن بالله ربا وعبد الله وآمن بالأنبياء واتبع الأنبياء والرسل كمن كان كافرا جاحدا بالله ورسله مستهزئا بالله ورسله. ولقد قال الكافرون لنبيكم عليه الصلاة والسلام في مكة يومها، قالوا: يا محمد تعال نعبد إلهك سنة وتعبد إلهنا وأوثاننا وتعبد أوثاننا سنة. فأنزل الله على نبيه وحيا يتلى إلى يوم القيامة: قل يا أيها الكافرون. أمر الله نبيه أن يخاطبهم بهذه الكلمة: يا أيها الكافرون، لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد. هكذا أمر الله نبيه أن يخاطبهم بهذه الكلمة الفيصل بين المؤمن والكافر. فما لهؤلاء القوم لا يفقهون حديثا؟ يريدون أن يبدلوا كلام الله ويريدون أن يحرفوا شرع الله، فيقولون: من كان خلقه جيد فهو حسن عند الله، ومن عامل الناس معاملة حسنة فهو حسن عند الله. لا ورب الأرض والسماء لا يستوون عند الله. لا يستوي من كفر بالله، من شتم الله، من نسب إلى الله ما لا يليق به، بالمؤمن الموحد الذي عبد الله ولم يشرك به شيئا واعتقد في قلبه الصفات التي تليق بالله. أيها المؤمنون، إن هذا هو الحق الذي ذكره الله في كتابه، أن الله تعالى لم يجعل في الآخرة المؤمن كالكافر، وإلا لما أرسل الرسل ولما توعد بآيات وآيات بعذاب أليم. لمن؟ للكافرين الذين كانوا في هذه الدنيا لا يؤمنون به أو ينسبون إليه ما لا يليق به. فقوله تبارك وتعالى: فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر، هذا على التهديد، وليس معناه أن الله خير الإنسان، بل تتمة الآية: إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها وإن يستغيثوا يغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه بئس الشراب وساءت مرتفقا. الله تعالى ذكر هذا العذاب الأليم، والمهل هو الماء المتناهي في الغليان، أنه أعده الله في نار جهنم، وذكر صفة منه أنهم إذا استغاثوا أغيثوا به. وماذا يفعل هذا الماء؟ يشوي الوجوه، شدة العذاب الأليم. أفيكون هؤلاء مرضيون عند الله؟ أفيكون هؤلاء إخوة للمؤمنين في الآخرة على المعنى الذي يذكرونه بعض الناس؟ كلا ورب الأرض والسماء لا يستوون عند الله. فالكافر ليس له بعد أن يخرج من الدنيا إلا الخزي وإلا العذاب والنكد المهين والعياذ بالله تعالى. حتى أعمالهم التي فعلوها في الدنيا من إطعام الجائع وإيواء المنكوب ليس لهم عند الله فيها ذرة من الحسنات. وهذا قول الله أوضح وأصرح في ذلك، وهو قوله تعالى: فقدمنا إلى ما عملوا من عمل فجعلناه هباء منثورا. بعد كل هذه الآيات يأتيك من يقول: الناس سواسية عند الله، وأن من كفر بالله فإن الله تعالى لن يعذبه. كلا ورب الأرض والسماء لا يستوون عند الله، لأن الله تعالى أخبر في القرآن بآيات وآيات أن المؤمنين، من هم المؤمنون؟ الذين اعتقدوا بالله ربا، عبدوا الله ليس كمثله شيء، ونزهوه عن صفات المخلوقين، لهم الكرامة يوم القيامة، ولهم العز والفخر، وأن الكافرين لهم الهوان والذل يوم القيامة. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يختم لنا منه بخير أجمعين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فيا فوز المستبشرين.
They will tell you Allah exists without a place like us. Allah doesn't resemble anything like us. Allah is not sitting on the throne like us. Tawassul like us. Tabarruk like us. About the bid'ah issues like us. But they reach a place where we continue and they stop. And them stopping here is something that takes them out of Islam. Like those people who say, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى. Ibn Taymiyyah, even though that he used to believe that Allah is a body sitting on the throne, even though that Ibn Taymiyyah used to believe that Allah has a weight, he is a body, a physical body, I don't say that he is a kafir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَنْ لَمْ يُعْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَإِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا للكافرين سعيرا. Anybody who doesn't believe in Allah and His Messenger, Allah prepared for the blasphemers hellfire. Allah called them blasphemers. Allah called those who don't believe in Allah and His Messenger what? Blasphemers. What do you want me to call them? If Allah called them blasphemers, what do you want me to call them? So they come and they fool people. Ibn Taymiyyah say that he's a mujassim, say that he used to believe a corrupted belief, but don't say he was a kafir. So anybody who claims now in America or wherever in the whole earth, and Ibn Taymiyyah, despite his corrupted belief, we cannot judge that he's a kafir. He is the kafir. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى. He is the blasphemer. Why? Because he is as if he is saying Allah Ta'ala is a liar. Allah mentions in the Quran that anybody who doesn't believe in Allah, he is what? A blasphemer. And someone like him comes and tells you, don't say he's a blasphemer. What do you want me to call a kafir? But subhanallah, money. Money! Money! The devil bought lots of souls with money. But some people, before drinking from the well of Sheikh Abdullah, they didn't even know the difference between istinja and istibra. Sheikh Abdullah taught them. But after Sheikh Abdullah died, subhanallah al-azim, lots of them deviated to the point that some of those who drank from the well of Sheikh Abdullah nowadays, they say Ibn Taymiyyah is not a kafir. We don't judge Ibn Taymiyyah as a kafir, even though he said Allah is a body sitting on the throne. Allah says in the Quran, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ, which means Allah doesn't need his creation. The one who's sitting down like you, need the chair or not? You answer. I'm sitting on a chair. Do I need the chair or not? So the one who is sitting on something needs it. And Allah says in the Quran, what means he doesn't need anything. So the one who claims that Allah is sitting on the throne is going against the verse فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ, is belying that verse. And whoever belies the Quran, what is his judgment? He is a kafir.